It's the local churches, the Lord's Recovery, the so-called Lord's Recovery, little by little, to the point that they will, that the students who come into this group, they will be completely sold out for this group and eventually will want nothing more to do with any other group. That's a big red flag when you don't want to have anything to do with any other Christian group. You become so exclusive. I'm going to get into that in another video about how they really like to talk about oneness and being inclusive and just accepting all Christians. Actually, it's quite the contrary. They're actually very exclusive and have an elitist theology from Witness Lee. So I'll get into that in another video. But you know, what typically happens, what starts to happen with a student is when the student gets sold out for this group, you know, they begin to spend a lot of time with this group. Usually on a college campus, there are several home meetings throughout the week. So they try to have different home meetings every night to cater to your convenience. And they oftentimes encourage students to go to multiple home meetings every week. And these home meetings are, you know, usually 2 to 3 hours long. They're not usually just, you know, 30 minutes. It's usually a full meal, you know, with singing and then Bible study. And then you have dessert afterwards, a good conversation. And they want you to go to multiple home meetings every week. They want you to go to college retreats, which are several days long and happen multiple times a year. They're going to eventually want you to go to their local church meetings, which are very long, in which there are multiple local church meetings every week. So eventually what happens is a student who sold out for this group finds himself or herself spending days and many hours with this group, and oftentimes to the neglect of their own family and to the neglect of others who they used to know in the past. And oftentimes that's a red flag. When a group isolates you and alienates you from your family and from other Christians, that becomes a red flag. And at first it may not seem like that. At first it might not. But once you really get into this group, that's exactly what happens. And you know, one of the main goals, again, of these campus workers is to get you to go to their full-time training Bible school in Anaheim, California. And so naturally you would suspect that family members and friends of these new local church members start to become concerned because they're not seeing their son or their daughter or their brother or their sister as much as they used to. And they're with this group that is reading, you know, Witness Lee all the time. And so, you know, naturally family members and friends start to become very concerned. And I'm going to do that. One of the next videos that I'm going to do is going to be on how the local churches will grab and occupy your time very, very much. And that's one characteristic of a cult, is they're time grabbers. They're going to occupy you just like a Jehovah's Witnesses. I think Jehovah's Witnesses require you to have 5 meetings a week, to go to 5 different Christian meetings a week. If you do that, you're hardly going to have enough time to not only care for yourself, but care for your own family. And so that's typical of cults like Jehovah's Witnesses. The local churches are no different. They're going to grab your time. They're going to occupy you. They want you to be completely sold out for this group. So that's a big red flag. I'm going to get into that in one of the next videos. So please consider, I know that this is a long series right now that I'm doing on the campus ministry of Witness Lee, of the local churches. But just please consider, instead of, you know, plainly laying out who they are, what church they are, who they read, what they believe, what they want from you, instead of doing that, being upfront, clear, transparent, they do the exact opposite. That is cult behavior. When a group hides the church that they go to and have multiple different aliases hiding who they really are, they don't even bring their own Bible to the group so as to appear normal. They don't mention the very author that they so dearly love and read every day of their lives. They refuse to mention who he is. And then they invite you into their homes or invite themselves into your home. Meanwhile, they continue to hide who they are, what they believe. And while they inoculate you, basically trying to convince you underhandedly how witness is really good, you know, these people are being very opaque. They're being very non-transparent. They're being very hidden in who they are. And that is wrong. We should never be embarrassed or hide who we are, especially as Christians. Especially as Christians. But these people are not Christians. They are a cult. They are deceived, and they're deceiving others. You can call it what you want. You can call it, well, we're just trying not to scare people away. We're just trying not to, you know, scare prospective members away. No, what they're doing is sneaky, subtle, downright deceptive. They purposefully do not show their true colors. They purposefully don't show you who they read every morning and every day. They purposefully don't tell you up front about where they want you to go, the Bible school they want you to go to, and what church they want you to go to. They leave it all out. And what's funny is that a lot of the old school local church members, you know, the ones who came in the 60s and the 70s, the veterans of the local churches, a lot of them actually have a serious aversion to the modern, up-to-date tactics of the local church's ministry. A lot of the old school members don't like what's going on and have publicly spoken out against it. Even some of the leaders of the local churches, kind of the old school leaders, the ones who are the old guard, the veterans, even they have spoken out against it. Why? Because they realize that it's being crafty, it's being deceptive. And you know, these ones from the 60s and the 70s, they grew up and they lived as people who were just unashamed of who they were, and they didn't want to hide who they were. But they realized this newer generation is really hiding who they are, and they're being quite crafty, quite subtle, really deceptive. And so they've spoken out against it. You know, maybe it's because they have more of a conscience. I don't know. Maybe they're just not as crafty and subtle as this new generation. I don't know. Either way, one thing is for sure, these new tactics by the local churches are very much a form of hiding who they are, who they really are, who they, you know, what they believe, what they read, and what they want from you. And any group that has to hide who they are, that is a red flag. If they hide behind different names, they hide their Bibles, they purposefully leave out information regarding their group, huge red flag, run, run, run. It is a cult. And this local church's Lord's Recovery, the Christians on Campus, or whatever other name they have, it is a cult, a deceptive, sneaky cult. Shame on them for doing what they are doing. Shame on them for deceiving young, impressionable college students. Shame on them. They need to repent. And so how I'm going to end this video is, you know, there's a lot of things online that expose the local churches and Witness Lee. And, you know, I've read a lot of things online before. Some of it is good. Some of it may not be that accurate. You know, there's not everything that you may read about there is accurate. But I found one person who is an ex-member of the local churches and whose father was basically a co-worker of Witness Lee. So this guy that I've been reading some of, his father was like a co-worker of Witness Lee. And this guy, he grew up in the local churches, unlike me. I didn't grow up in it, but he grew up in the local churches. And thank God he got out. I don't think his parents did, but he did. And he wrote, he's written a lot of things. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to close this video with reading some of the things that he wrote that really apply to the subtle deceptive tactics of Witness Lee in the local churches on college campuses. So I'm just going to read some of the things. This guy, this ex-local church member, really has a way with words. Seems like a very intelligent person. So I'm just going to start reading, okay? I really enjoyed it. I hope you do too. He says, this plastic worldview of the local churches, this fake reality that they have, is inserted into the faith, all caps, faith of the member, until loyalty to Witness Lee and his group become the faith of that member. So basically, they're going to overturn